Daniel.
Hi.
Morning.
Afternoon.
Yeah, that's what I meant. it was fine. Just went later than I thought it would.
Tonight? Yeah, that'd be great. Oh, that sounds cool.
Do you want me to just, should I meet you there or,
Yeah. Okay, great. I will see you then.
Yeah, we gotta go check out.
Okay, bye.
Hi.
I have to pee. You wanna hurry up and pack? We're meeting Lauren and Steve for breakfast.
Okay.
So, let's not linger here or anything.
No, no. We won't. But there's this little place I want to take you to. It has the most amazing funnel cakes. Mm. No trip to Orcus is complete without them. And then after that, we're going to come back here and watch the sunset. Because nothing moves the spirits more than being here and watching the sunset.
But, Peter, you can't just plan the whole day without consulting me. I mean,
Well, thanks for getting out of bed in time.
Hey. Yeah. Thank you for waiting.
Sorry.
Good morning. Afternoon. What time is it? I have no idea.
Remember how it is when you're in a new relationship, stuck in a romantic hotel.
Yeah. We figured you'd be spooning all day and we'd never see you again. So we were just going to take the ferry over to the other islands.
Oh.
But can we have a rain check?
Yeah.
We have a connecting flight out of Seattle on the 18th.
Well, let's do it then.
Yeah. There's this great old hotel. It's the old Excelsior. They have this great high tea, and I promised Lars that I'd take her for a long time now. So why don't you join us for that? The old Excelsior is a great high tea in the afternoon.
Great. On the 18th?
Yeah.
18th, 3 o'clock.
Okay.
3 o'clock not good?
No, it's okay. Good, so we'll do 3 o'clock on the 18th.
Okay.
3 o'clock on the 18th.
Okay.
Four of us on the 18th. At 3.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
So good to see you, too. Mm-hmm.
Don't hold too long. There
okay,
you
sorry.
Go.
Be good to him. He's the best.
You do what you can, though, right?
Yeah.
And I'm going to get Susie's number.
Good, okay.
Just in case this doesn't work out.
I'm kidding.
Hey. See you guys later.
So you have dinner tonight with Daniel and Maya and Ray.
I tried to tell you I had plans.
No, it's okay. I should probably get you back into town. Thank you.
Thanks.
That was amazingly accurate. Would you like to do my shirt? Need some help there?
I got it. Thank you. It's good. It's fine.
Okay. Why are you trying to push me away?
Last night, it was make-believe.
Well, yeah, it started out that way. Yeah, sure. Then it changed. Caught me totally by surprise. It was great.
I was drunk.
Mm-hmm. So?
It was a mistake.
It was incredible. It was passionate.
You're making more of this than it is.
Why? I don't get it. I don't understand why.
Okay, you want the truth?
Please, I'd love the truth.
You remember how I told you how connected I am to my mom?
Mm-hmm, sure.
Well, I didn't tell you the whole story.
So you channel her by drawing a line on a placement? All right, sorry.
And you, number 6.
Wow. My God. Amy, you were 7. So she was just, giving you something to hang on to. Help you cope with losing her, not to burden you for your entire life.
I have not been burdened.
Yeah, but you of all people should realize that life is not that predictable. I mean, look at how your mother died at such a young age. You know, there's just so many incredible, wonderful things that you can't plan for, that just happen, that you don't put on a list. You know, it's... See, the problem with the timeline is it doesn't allow you spontaneity. You know? It doesn't allow you to take chances.
I have taken plenty of chances.
Oh, yeah? Prove it. Take a chance with me.
Okay. It's just not gonna go any further with us.
All right, can I ask you one more question?
Yeah.
What do you do now? What happens after number 7?
What do you mean?
Well, are you gonna have kids now, or get a doctorate? Climb Mount Fuji? What are you gonna do?
I don't know how it ends.
It's gonna be a big change for you, going through life without a checklist. Come on. Let's go.
I need your shirt.
Forget about it.
I'm a mess. Come on.
You look fine.
Peter, will you just give me your shirt?
Whatever.
Close your eyes.
We just made love. I've seen everything there is to see.
Will you just close
them? What are you, 5? Fine. It's like an adolescent.
That was you.
Hi. Oh, God, we had car trouble, and then I got syrup in my shirt.
Can I open my eyes?
Yes, of course. Yes, Peter, you remember Daniel? Daniel, hey, Peter.
Thanks for getting her back safely.
Handled her with care.
Well, yeah.
Thanks.
I called you on my cell phone. My and Ray were a little worried about you.
Wow, you look incredible.
So I'll just see you at the store, okay?
Bye.
Sorry.
Missed you last night.
You did?
Yeah.
Thinking hold up in a mini market. I was thinking, who is Peter and can we really trust him?
I'm 5 minutes late.
Exactly. Oh, you. Oh, you look amazing. Really?
Yeah, hostess said to give her another second.
Why don't we get you guys a drink while we wait, huh?
Martini?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Daniel, do you golf?
Yeah, it's my favorite game.
How'd it go?
Oh, you know, went.
Good. Then this stupid charade better be over, because I will die if you blow up with this guy. I mean, I never thought you'd be with someone we actually liked.
Oh, God, Amy. It's perfect for you.
I think?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Amy, I like this guy.
You do?
Yeah.
There you go.
Ooh.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Table's ready.
Okay. I have some good news for you.
What's that?
I got my test results.
Oh, are you taking a class or something?
No, I mean, for you and me?
Yeah.